The Blackmagic Camera app just received a new update. Now you can use the app also on iPads and you can remotely control multiple iOS devices from just one device. I tried out the new features and simulated a typical studio that you could use, for example, for a talking head video with an overhead camera for an unboxing. For the different camera angles, I used some older iOS devices, like for example the iPhone 14 Pro Max, the iPhone 12 mini, an iPad Air in the 4th generation, and an iPad Pro in the 5th generation. And the desk is my older iPhone 6s Plus, which cannot install iOS 17. So it's not possible to run the new Blackmagic app because it needs at least iOS 17. But I can use it as a stopwatch so we can see if the feed to the camera is synchronized over all the different cameras, or if we see a lag, like for example here you see a slight lag. And from the controller device I can switch between the different cameras, change the settings, and switch like this, or go to an overview and get all four camera angles at once. And I also can change settings individually, like for example if I change the white balance here to a more yellow, you would see the yellow just on this camera. But if I long press here, I can link the controls, and if I change the white balance, for example now, and go back, now it's all the same, and I change it to more yellow and go here, then all the different cameras use the same white balance. Okay, let's put this on auto again and switch to the overview. And if I press here, I start the recording on all the devices at once. If I go to an device, I see a red frame around the image showing that it is recording. The recordings are stored on the device itself and have to be downloaded afterwards. And if you want to stop the recording, you just press here. And let me show you the settings. If you go to the settings, there's a new menu item, Remote Camera Control. And this iPad is used as a controller. But if I go, for example, to this device and go here in the settings, I first have to stop. You go here and then you eject the different cameras. So now I can go here and have the control and go to settings and remote camera control. And here you see that it's configured as remote camera. I can give a camera name like front, set a remote password, I just put one letter inside, and set that the camera is available for control and monitoring. So, and that's a quick overview about the new features in the Blackmagic Camera app. I hope you liked it. If you did, please leave me a like. For more videos like this, subscribe, and I see you in the next one. Bye-bye.